Allahu Akbar.
So how can we have an institutionalized approach to counter institutionalized Islamophobia? That should we should think about. And I would say that there are two levels. One is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing, and wallahu khairul makirin, that's the ayah in the Quran Majid. And we have seen the real practical tafsir of this ayah in the United States and in the West. For example, means what happened after Muslim ban? That sympathy from the general public or population of America, it was unthinkable. Means nobody thought about that. Means I like to know any Muslim expert who would have predicted that there will be a lot of support from the American population for Muslim against Muslim ban. But it happened. Yes, we are living in an era of nightmares and sweet dreams at the same time. That's the Muslim community living here. However, that this wallahu khairul makirin, that tafsir is this type of demonstration in support of Muslims. And for example, a support and the solidarity with Muslims in different towns. I live in Frederick, Maryland, almost 45, 50 miles from here. It's a small town. We have Jummah prayer in the long weekend, around 400 people. And after the Muslim ban, some young Christian couples, one couple especially, they talk to each other, and they create that we have to do something for Muslims. And they created a Facebook page. And then they talk to the Muslim leadership over there, that we like to do something for Muslims. This is wrong. But whatever is going on, this is wrong. This is not America. This is not American values. So with the consultation, they decided after a week that we will have a demonstration as a solidarity to Muslim around the mosque, and then we will have speeches. So it was a bitter cold evening on that Friday. 1,200 people from Frederick, of different faith, they got together. They have a big round of walk and then speeches. And I saw white old ladies on wheelchairs, and they were there for the Muslims, supporting Muslims. I saw young couples with infant children, but they're also walking that bitter cold just to show their solidarity with Muslims. And then the speeches, the congressman, the city mayor, the state assembly woman, state senator, county, city mayor, county chair, everybody, interfaith people, Jewish rabbi, reverend, everybody came and spoke out for the Muslim and supporting Muslims. So not only that, but I think Professor Shibli Talhami also wrote a piece in Washington Post on February 26. His institution, University of Maryland, they did a survey, four surveys during the election campaign. And the conclusion was that it's a strange twist that when the Republican candidates, especially Donald Trump, they were speaking against Muslims, American public opinion was increasing in support of Muslims. So he gave a chart also he gave that the first survey they did in October 15, and the favorable opinion for Muslim among the American public was 43%. And last survey, what they did before the election campaign in October 16, the favorable opinion was 70%. Same thing, the Pew people also came up with a survey that they also told us that thermometer, they examine a thermometer type conclusion that 7 or 8% increase in favor of Muslims in 16 and 17. So that thing, these actions are also happening on one level. And that we can say that wallahu khairul makirin, that is the Allah's help, unintended consequences, and the support and the sympathy is increasing. So the sweet dreams are increasing, but nightmares are still there. So then the second level is what we have to do as an individual, as a mosque, as a national organizations or local chapters, as a scholar, as an activist, what we have to do. So I think already our speakers, they have mentioned, but these are the five areas. Very quickly, social service area. ICNA Relief has been doing that, domestic relief. I think we have participated more than 41. Disasters last 4 or 5 years. And with the help of other religious groups, Lutheran, Christian, Jewish, the Islamic centers, wherever in Sandy and different type of disaster. And also it was recognized by the New York State Assembly. It was recognized by the New Jersey different mayors. So it was recognized by the New York Police Department that yes, Muslim participated in these disaster relief work and they helped the general population. They help everybody, not only Muslim, they help everybody. Then we have back to school giveaway every year. And we like to expand that. So these are the institutional response that we like to have back to school giveaway for every student in every state. But we need help. We need help from the community. We need help from the Islamic centers. So that is also a best response. I remember once we had a meeting with the, President Obama's community advisor. He's a young fellow, lawyer from Howard Law School. Could you, if you remember the name of that? I don't remember the name. We were talking to him once during Ms. Obama's presidency. And when I told him that this is the ICNA Relief campaign, our campaign, back to school giveaway, he was saying that is the response. Because this Islamophobia, this bigotry, it's not going away 1 year. It will take maybe 5, 10 years, or maybe more than that. But we have to have this response of working social service, not only for Muslims, but for everybody, for our neighbors, for our any student, needy student, we have to work with them. So that is the one response. Second is the social justice issue. And social justice doesn't mean only the hijab issue or discrimination issue or our wrong media portrayal. No, the racism, the inequality here, the family problem, unjust immigration reform, health issues, all those issues which are inner city violence, youth problem, Muslims have to speak up. So ICNA also started ICNA Council for Social Justice. So not social justice only for Muslims, but every American Muslims have to be on the table and present the position. What is the Islamic position? What is the Islamic perspective? And what type of actions are needed? And Muslims have to participate in those. Third thing is already a lot of things were said about the coalition building. Interfaith with civil organizations, local levels, state level, national level. We have to do that. Masajid should be involved, individuals should be involved, national organizations should be involved, and we have to work on that level. Media, there's a lot of things, mashallah, CARE is doing that, but not only just writing, I think before writing, just if we try to develop the habit of making comments on different news stories. All our young ones, they are very good and quick on their smartphone. If you read a story, and then just make a comment. It's a wonderful story. It's an awesome story. It's a very bad story. Something like that. And write a one paragraph, two sentences about that story and send it to that, whoever is the newspaper or TV story or the correspondent. That will make a difference. Because if you see that sometime, the story is in favor of Muslims. And down the story, if you see, there are 300 comments. 90% comments are against the story, against Muslims. Because a lot of people, they are very active on that. Maybe they are hired by some institutions just to make comments. I think I will especially say our young one to be vigilant and make this habit, develop this habit. And you are very good in networking. OK, this is a story. If it is a good story, appreciate that. If it is a bad story, negative story, make a criticism, but make this habit and network among your own youth to do that. So this comments brigade, comments making whole youth network, we are very much in need. And last thing also, I remember once we have Ms. conference call with Professor Hatem Bazian about this Islamophobia and countering, and he said a wonderful thing that this is the local level response, local level civic engagement is very much needed. Alhamdulillah, Muslims have traveled a lot politically since September 11. But now the voter registration and all those, but the involvement at the local level in the local election. But more than that, I think we should go to the next level. And next level is Muslims should also become a candidate. Do some bargaining wherever you have some weight. You have organized vote. You have organized also a dollar note. And you have time.